Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Diego and today we're gonna be recording outside because it's a beautiful day. Hold up. Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Diego and the sun could be a little bit higher. Yep, this is good now. You see, I tried recording in the morning and then a couple of hours later and now I'm here and I like how the sun looks like because I'm living in real life. Well, when it comes to CGI, you have that one HDRI that you use. You know, it's like a sunny HDRI, fixed sun position, and that's practically it. If that sun doesn't work the way you wanted it to work, well, you have a problem. You need to search for a different one, etc. But what if I told you that you can have one full day, 24 hour, of HDRIs, 5 minute time intervals. And you can browse through those time intervals in your viewport and see live reaction in your render. Like if you wanna get the time for 250, you get the 250 HDRI. If you want 255, you get the 255 HDRI. I'm not talking about tilting the image. I'm talking 24 hour, 5 minute interval images. Sounds a little bit crazy, but check this out.
So here we're talking about this little company called Stableworks, and they have this amazing product that's called Vermeer. Now, they are creating HDRIs. How on earth are their HDRIs better than, you know, what else is on the market? Well, they have a specific approach to their HDRIs, and the process of creation is actually a little bit crazy. So look at this, I just loaded their HDRI in Photoshop, so this is like a sunset HDRI. Get this, if I go to exposure, and if I tone down the exposure, so okay, we see the sun, let me just zoom in. So if I tone down the exposure, you can actually see sun starting to get turned off. So you see, this is the thing. Every HDRI that I've seen, their HDRI recording methods don't go as low with the exposure as this. And they usually, you know, fake those darkness moments either by toning down those few last brackets of HDRIs in Photoshop, or they just paint in the dot for the sun, you know, just to fake that extra kick. Well, these guys actually managed to record that, and they managed to do that by using this monstrosity of the machine, which has multiple cameras, some sort of computers on the bottom. It's just a little bit crazy. Not only that, every HDRI that they record, they use exposure meter and spectrometer to check the consistency between different locations, time frames, whatever. The other thing is they even check how big was the fog or the haze that day, because their HDRI solution has this feature that when you load in a specific day into your scene, and if you click the atmosphere button, it's gonna load in an actual atmosphere from that day, so you get a super realistic result. Now, all this sounds a little bit crazy, but it's actually super simple. Let me show you in Max how that's done. So first thing, when you download their pack, one thing that you get is this Vermeer Sky script. So you click on that and you get this little sun and this little kind of helper box, and you get this menu. So whenever you right click or click on anything else, and when you click on this little sun, you get this little menu. First thing that you need to do, let's just move it up, let's say to here, is click load. So when you click load, it loads up an HDRI in your viewport and it all looks fine. Now, before we start the actual render, when you click on the overview button, it actually shows the list of days that you can have with their HDRIs. So let me choose the clear winter morning. Now, take a look at this. Here you have this little kind of browsing button. And look at this, if you just go to the right, look what happens. Let me just adjust my viewport a little bit better. All of these are the current HDRIs that are being loaded. And this is from the actual day. And this is all, I think, like 10 minute frame interval. And you get a natural realistic light from this. But how does that look in the render? So let me fire up my Corona here and click on Start Interactive. So this is how it looks like. One of the things, let me just go to maybe a higher sun position. Let's say something like this. You can even choose those sun positions directly from the overview button that I clicked that got me here. You see, you can like choose various sun moments. Now, the thing that I was pretty amazed with this, every time when I would load up a specific HDRI, any HDRI, you know, just HDRI that you regularly use, my background was never like super consistent with the amount of lighting that my objects were getting in the scene. With this, I literally have a feeling like this teapot and a plane are on this big field. I mean, look at it, like when I rotate it, it just, I don't know, it matches nicely. The other thing is, you can notice that the texture here, you know, from the HDRI is actually a little bit blurry, and I did mention that these guys can go up to 20,000 pixel resolution. Now, they have this thing where you can just browse, you know, all these different, you know, times of the day in real time, but if you want to get, you know, a high resolution image, you have the LOD part here, which is like a level of detail, and you can choose the high version. So let me just take this one and just increase the exposure to, let's say, something like this. And now when you click on the high button, it loads in a high resolution HDRI, the 20,000 pixel one. Look at this, look how sharp that looks. I mean, it's completely crisp, and the light feels so damn natural. That's the crazy part about it. Now, another cool thing is, I'm in Corona right now, right? And if I want to switch to another rendering engine, if I click here and just switch on the F-Storm, for example, and I open up the RT mode, it will open up that same scene. And so that means that you won't need to switch. You know, you won't need to reset up the whole Vermeer. If you just switch from one engine to another engine, it will just convert automatically. And this is super cool about it. So now let me just lower down this exposure a little bit. Let's say something like this. Okay, now, atmosphere. Remember when I said that every HDRI has that info about the fog and the distance, etc. If you click the simulate atmosphere, you're actually getting the exact atmosphere from that day. So if, like, for example, the visibility that day was 10 kilometers, you're gonna get your atmosphere to be set on 10 kilometer distance. So they're really, really keeping all the natural boundaries of this whole thing. Another cool thing, if you go to the overview and you can just pick any other day, let's say sunny summer afternoon. This is a chunk of the day which was recorded on a sunny summer afternoon. Just lower the exposure a little bit more, and let's lower down the sun to this position, for example. And this is now cool. If you scroll down here, you get these adjustments: blur, saturation, contrast, horizon. If you crank up the blur a little bit, your shadow is automatically going to be blurred. You see this? On the other hand, saturation will desaturate the image a little bit, contrast will add contrast, horizon will literally shift the horizon, which will literally interact with the shadows and everything. There's actually a couple of more fun things that you can do here. You can actually save your favorites by pressing this little heart button, or when you are in the overview window, let's say here, if you want to choose a specific time of the day, let's say I want to choose, I don't know, sunset, it will load up a sunset, and you can have a list of all the packages that you have from them that have a sunset, and you can just choose which sunset you like. Clear winter day sunset, see this, dramatic winter afternoon, hazy autumn, it just doesn't matter. And now here's the thing, every image that you load here, you can see on which date it was recorded, at what time it was recorded. So when you're just browsing these things, you can just see directly what is happening, what time frame you're in. It's just, it's very simple to use. Now, all this is cool when I'm showing it on a simple plane and a teapot, but how does this actually work in a real project? So I downloaded ArchExteriors Volume 42. It's this scene, and I'm gonna infuse it with some Vermeer power. Let's see what this will do with that scene. As you can see, we have a lot of lights here from cars, from windows, etc. By the way, check out this package, because if you buy this package, you also get this tropical scene, and it's all filled with props. You get all the props that you see here. Look, even this bird, it's yours. So I've loaded up the scene and I've added the Vermeer HDRI in it. It looks pretty, I would say it looks pretty realistic. Okay, now let's lower the sun down to something like this. And now you can just rotate your sun and just choose whichever angle you like, and you can just have that moment. You know, that's the fascinating part about it. If you need your sun to be lower or higher, you can just choose that part of the day, and the sun is just gonna go up or down. You can also see it here, if you take a look at the sun here, and if I, for example, increase the sun, you can see the little sun icon just moved up. And that's pretty much it. This is how it works. Now, check this thing out. If I just select the sun that we have from Vermeer, and if I clone it, and let's say here I want a different position, let's say something like this. I also want a different HDRI hazy spring, for example. I got this, let me just adjust my light a little bit. to, let's say, something like this, we get this image, and it's looking great. And I generally wanted to, you know, save this scenario. Now, the whole duplication of Vermeer suns gives you this possibility. If you just click on your previous sun, it will load in the Vermeer setup that you had for this sun, so you can actually have multiple of these with multiple, you know, light scenarios. So it's actually super practical. But one thing that's very specific about these guys, they are not wasting a single minute in a day. They even have night HDRIs. So for example, I selected dramatic winter afternoon. We all know that around 5 p.m., you know, it gets very dark outside, and this is the result that you get here. Now, let's even lower the sun a little bit more to, let's say, something like this. So this is 18 hours or 6 p.m. on a winter, and it's pretty dark compared to the light. So let's just increase our exposure to see where we're at. So exposure to 20, let's go 50, let's go even more, let's go 400, maybe more, 700. And this is the result that you get. You know, now you can just rotate the HDRI, it's gonna light up the scene, whatever, however you rotate it. Now let me go to, let's say, dawn, and let's go, for example, here where the sun is rising up. By the way, here you can see the little icons, and you can see which one is actually cloudy, which one is sunny, where is the night, where is not the night. Also, the colors that you see here, you can see those colors there. So it's kind of, you know, it's nicely organized. And look at this, we have a dawn now. Now you can just play with the sun however you like. And it's, you know, like, I spent, I think, like 2 hours yesterday just picking different lights, picking different suns, and every light just fits so naturally into the whole scene. It's a little bit crazy. I think it really is. Now, if you're wondering where can you get all these sexy Vermeer stuff, well, on their webpage, stableworks.tech. Here you have all the time frames, and you can just pick which one you like. You can even see those nice animations where you can see what you're getting with a specific HDRI. Also, if you decide to purchase one of these, you can use the code RenderRam20 and you can get 20% discount on these prices. So yeah, check out stableworks.tech. It's you know, like, it's like an instant photorealism. It's again, it's stupid. It's very stupid. Also, don't forget to check out EverMotion website for your daily news and informations. And that'll be it for today. See you in the next video. Bye.